G'day guys, how's it going? It is Jared HD here. Welcome to the 24th episode of our Aston Villa career mode for FIFA 19. Today's episode is going to be quite a big one. We are in September, out of the transfer window, and we have some big games in the Premier League, away to West Ham United, at home to Arsenal, and away to Liverpool. Also, we have a game in the Carabao Cup, away at Newport, which could be quite interesting, but very excited to see how we go in today's episode. But if you guys do go on to enjoy today's episode, make sure, as always, that you leave a like on the video. And if you are new around here, make sure you bloody scorpion kick that subscribe button down below. Thank you also for 25,000 subscribers on this channel. But we ain't here to mess about. We are gonna jump straight into the gameplay for today's episode, away at the Olympic Park as we take on West Ham United. It definitely hasn't been the strongest start to the Premier League season. Definitely not the start we would have wanted, but hopefully now that we've got our starting 11 sorted out of the transfer window, hopefully now we can just crack on here and get point after point, 3 points after 3 points. Sami Nasri's captain of West Ham, which is interesting, but this is going to be quite a interesting game. I feel like I've said interesting 400 times lately. And I mean, both ourselves and West Ham have really struggled to find the back of the net to start the season. So a big game for both of our clubs. So here we are taking a look at Pellegrini's West Ham United side. Lucas Fabianski starting in the goals there. Have they brought in that Powell guy? No idea who that is, but Frederick's in there. Declan Rice in CDM. They've got Fernandez, Sami Nasri, Assad. Not sure who that is. And Marko Arnautovic up front. So a weakish sort of side, leaving Felipe Anderson. And I think I saw Milik there. So interesting choices from Pellegrini. But our starting lineup is what we've come used to. Our back line looking very strong. Lascelles, Emerson in there. It's a very balanced side we have now. And I mean, if you've seen Avengers, we've got a balanced side of the universe. No, I fucked that up. I swear I always fuck up the one-liners in these videos. They win that header. Oh, they get first to it, but thankfully it's into the hands safely of Matty Ryan. Come on, we're looking to hit him on the counter. Hudson-Odoi running down the line here. Drag back. Cross. Townsend! Oh, great save from Lucas Fabianski. What a goal that would have been. Come on, lads. We're on the attack. Going through. Oh, get there. McGinn fouled. Shot. Good save. I thought he was fouled in the lead-up for sure there, though. They're on the attack here, West Ham. Arnautovic going through there. How have they got in front? Oh, he's offside. I was wondering why everyone was just seemingly in a holding pattern. We've been all over West Ham, but that would have been a big blow if we conceded. They're on the attack here, West Ham. They have a shot with Arnautovic, which rockets off the crossbar. Follow up, clear it, Lascelles. Oh, West Ham really starting to cause us some problems now. But can we hit them on the counter-attack before halftime? No, Hudson-Odoi. Nasri feeding that one through to Assad. Davies helping back in defense. It goes to Sami Nasri. We're jockeying. He has the shot, but it doesn't trouble us in the slightest. Win that, Philip. Good stuff, Maxi. Here we go. Hudson-Odoi through. Maxi tackled. We're just not having that killer fucking instinct today. Let's find that killer instinct. Come on, oh, for fuck's sake. Ball's being passed around here. Philip, over the top to Andros Townsend, who's going to flick it up. No, he's not. He's going to bring it down. Heavy touch. Come on, lads. 85th minute. McGinn to Grealish. La Croqueta. Nice La Croqueta as well. Out to Townsend. Somebody. Davies. 1-0. Get in there. What a goal. Tom Davies. We're going to take the lead here in the 85th minute. Beautifully worked team goal. Oh, can we hold on here? Tom Davies, in the last few episodes, has had a scoring renaissance. And we take the lead here. Look at this on the replay. Beautiful stuff from Grealish. Beautiful cross Townsend. And a great finish from Davies. Top bloody bins. West Ham, no, not like this. Assad. Save from Ryan. Let's calm it down. Come on, last minute of the game. Big kick. Let's just win that header. Nope, or we can just make sure they don't get enough time to put it back up the field. And there it is. That is a massive 3 points to kick off today's episode. We go away to the Olympic Stadium and take down West Ham United 1-0. Tom Davies proving to be the hero late on in this one. Now we are going to have a training session here. I'm going to be putting through a few of our youth academy players through their paces, trying to build them up so that when they get to the age to come to the starting squad, they can provide us a bit of an impact. So we're going to simulate it here. And Rose is going to go up to a 62 overall, which is good to see. A lot of other players going up quite a lot in stats. Another transfer offer here for McCurdy. He's been a little bit of a tough character, hasn't he? We've accepted a lot for him, but he consistently rejects them. Well, we're going to accept this one here. It is going to be from Dalkurd FF, and we're going to accept it for £280,000. But again, I don't like our chances of it going through. Now we are going to have a training session here. I'm going to be putting through a few of our youth academy players through their paces, trying to build them up so that when they get to the age to come to the starting squad, they can provide us a bit of an impact. So we're going to simulate it here. And Rose is going to go up to a 62 overall, which is good to see. A lot of other players going up quite a lot in stats. Another transfer offer here for McCurdy. He's been a little bit of a tough character, hasn't he? We've accepted a lot for him, but he consistently rejects them. Well, we're going to accept this one here. It is going to be from Dalkurd FF, and we're going to accept it for £280,000. But again, I don't like our chances of it going through. All right, here we go. We've taken down West Ham, but I tell you what, we're going to have to be from here. We're going to have to take our game from here to here if we want to get anything against Arsenal. I remember last season when we faced them at the Emirates, they put us to absolute shame. Probably our biggest loss ever in charge of Aston Villa. So the Gunners know how to get points against us. They know how to score against us. We need to be stronger here. Taking a look at the table, it's too early to really get an indication, but Wolves are absolutely flying. We sit in 8th position. So we're going to take a look at our starting lineup, and there's no real surprise. Exactly the same as it was against West Ham. I mean, up until the January window, unless we get some more injuries or something huge happens, this is going to be the side that we hopefully will be rocking 24/7 consistently. And now taking a look at Unai Emery's Arsenal side. Have they signed anybody? They've got one front in, and they've got Diaz in there, a big defender. I know that they sold Lacazette to PSG in the transfer window, so not expecting him. Mesut Ozil starting here, and why does the game always do that? Who is their strikers? I think I saw that it was Aubameyang. Yeah, Aubameyang and Timo Werner. Why does the game cut off their lineups like that all the time? Davies on the attack here, going back to Phillip, McGinn, 1-0, what a start, our first attack of the game, and McGinn with his fantastic left foot puts us in the lead. What a dream start. Leno stood no chance in the rainy conditions. Look at that, just the ball, the run, touch, bang, 1-0 Villa. Uh-oh, Arsenal on the attack here, Kolasinac. We're trying to defend here with Gilbert. That one gets swung into the area. Davies wins the ball back. Come on, lads. Counter-attack. Let's get it. Come on, Grealish. Feeding it through. What a ball to Phillip. Maxi. Bit of Maxi magic. Oh, save. I should have had that one earlier. I was trying so hard to concentrate. I should have had that one touch earlier, but we get a corner at least. Honestly, we are all over Arsenal in this one so far. This is a great start. Oh, Jamal. Terrible header. Ah, oh, we've been done there. Kolasinac, the Bosnian. What a save, Matty Ryan. Oh, with the feet. Denying Aubameyang a certain goal-scoring opportunity. Thank the Lord for that save. All right, it's corner now for Arsenal. First half stoppage time. Guendouzi sending that one in there. Aubameyang with the header. Are you kidding me? That's taken the slightest little deflection off of Timo Werner, who's put it in the back of the net. I hate it when they celebrate like this. It's 1-1 against Villa, mate. You haven't won the Champions League final. What are you celebrating with the bench for? But Timo Werner nods that one on, and Arsenal find an equaliser in first half stoppage time. Look how unlucky this is. I feel like all season we've been conceding the slightest little unlucky goals. Lascelles leaving Timo Werner wide open. Look at that. What is Lascelles doing? He didn't even try to header it. It just deflected off his face. Throw in here for us. It's going to be Townsend. Going back to Gilbert. Ball roll. To McGinn. Passing it around nicely. Davies, left foot off the crossbar. Follow up. No, they've won it away. Oh, we could have reclaimed the lead there. Uh-oh. Cleaned him up there. Our big save, Matt Ryan. McGinn winning the ball there. Good stuff. Townsend. Passing it around everywhere. Townsend through to Davies. Through. Phillip. Phillip. Oh, what a save. Was that a save or a deflection or a block shot, I mean, from Socrates? I thought that was going to be the lead. Oh, it's come off the shin of Socrates. We just can't find a winner. They are on the attack, Arsenal. Timo Werner being chased by Llorente. He whips that one in there. Terrible cross. And now we're going to find ourselves on the counter. Adoy. Going to Phillip. I see you, Grealish. Jackie boy. He's going to go for the drag back. He's just going to hold it up anyways. Davies. Back. Grealish. Shot. Oh, low driven at Leno. A load of highlights in this one, but it's still 1-1. Grealish in. Lascelles. Jamal Lascelles scores against Arsenal. His first goal for the club. And that might just get us 3 points here against Arsenal. He ran onto it like an absolute bullet train. I think it was earlier in this game. He had a similar opportunity that he just nodded so far wide it wasn't funny. But this time, look at him. Watch him on the edge of the box there, running in, flying, and putting that one in the back of the net. 2-1 Aston Villa. All right, we are going to make a double substitution here, getting some fresh legs on to see out the final few moments. Ito and Jedinak on, and it's going to be Hudson-Odoi and Grealish off. There will be a minimum of Aubameyang on the attack here. Going through, save from Ryan. Come on, lads. We need to keep this one away here. We can't slack off. We want all 3 points here. We want to climb further up the table. Get to that Ryan. Punches it away. Not confident, though. Özil! Oh my god, Mesut Özil almost scored a screamer. But there it is. That is the full-time whistle. And that is 3 massive points for Villa. What a start to the episode it has been. 3 points against West Ham and 3 points against Arsenal. A classic game here against Arsenal. And we'll take it. Another transfer offer here for Jake Doyle-Hayes. It is the man that, just like McCurdy, is being a real pain in the ass. We're going to accept this one. I'm not even going to try pronunciating that club's name, but £240,000. Just leave, mate. So it is going to be our first game in the Carabao Cup this season. We are away to Newport County, and I'm rocking an extremely, extremely weak side here. For the most part, at least. Mostly all rotational. Of course, I would like to go far in the Carabao Cup, but honestly, not too worried about it in the grand scheme of things. So, good opportunity for a lot of players to get some game time here. And we're going to take the lead. It is Ferrari, our scout future star, giving us the lead on the stroke of half time. 20 minutes to go here, making some substitutions. Ferrari picks up a knock, which is not the news we wanted, but it is going to be a 1-0 victory against Newport away, so into the next round of Carabao Cup. No real surprise, Harry McCurdy's transfer talks have broken down with Dalkurd. Get stuff, mate. And no, Francesco Ferrari has suffered a lateral collateral ligament injury and he's gonna be spending 2 months on the sidelines. That's not good. I wanted to slowly build him up this season and start implementing him. That's frustrating. All right, another transfer offer for our best mate, Harry Bloody McCurdy. I'm going to accept it, but my expectations are very, very low. West Ham, done. Win. Arsenal, another win. Newport, a third win. But Liverpool, what a challenge they're going to be here. The final game of today's episode, it's a trip away to Anfield against, I mean, at the time of recording, the potential Premier League champions. They're currently ahead of Man City, who have a game against Leicester, but they're going to be a tough side nonetheless. No Alisson, which is interesting. They've brought in Trippier, they've brought in Akanji. Very strong back line there. Midfield is quite weak. What's the front line looking like? It is Salah, Cavani, and Mane. fair bloody enough. They've got Goretzka, Boateng on the bench as well. Klopp's done a mad one. And then, yep, you guessed it, our starting lineup exactly the same as it was in the games against West Ham and Arsenal. The only differences are on the bench. Of course, Ferrari out through injury, so that has allowed us to bring on O'Hare, I believe it is, the centre midfielder. Yeah, O'Hare to come into the bench. Beautiful stuff here. Oh, Philip sending Van Dijk back to bloody Southampton. Grealish, oh, we just almost pulled off one of the greater goals you'll ever see. Imagine if we got that after the flicker. Davies, though, feeding it through beautifully. Let's send that one deep. Oh, Hudson-Odoi. Almost sending that one top bins. What a start. Salah's going through here. It's fallen for them. And Geiger puts it over. Mane, beautiful stuff. Oh my God, I thought Mane was going to score a screamer. Ajarie going through. Cavani, an absolute rocket there. I was not expecting that. Corner here for Liverpool. Mane is going to go short to Mo Salah. Townsend just jockeying with him. Continuing to jockey here. Mo Salah goes short. It goes back to Salah. They won't lose possession here, Liverpool. They win the header. Oh, that is just frustrating. That is so frustrating. Cavani's height has really destroyed us there. And we're behind to Liverpool. They've been very strong in this game. But of all the goals to concede, that one is quite frustrating. Who was it marking him? Was that Lascelles or Llorente? I think, yeah, that was Llorente. He's been out-jumped there. He's not a short man himself. It's gone through the hands of Matt Ryan. Frustrating keeping from him. Oh, and it's going to be 1-0 Liverpool. Liverpool continuing to attack here. They go through to Mane. You're kidding me. Oh my God. Mane has just absolutely put us to the sword there. We are 2-0 down. We've just conceded 2 goals in the space of 5 minutes. Gilbert, you can't give Mane the near post like that. You can't give him the goal side option. Puts his laces through it. And that is 2-0. Far out. Come on. Oh, look at the run from Philip. Maxi, so much space. They're chasing in. Focus, Jared. Hits it. Green times. That's 2-1. Let's go and I was going to celebrate with the away fans, but we get a goal back. It's game on. Pick that bloody ball up. Maxi green times it. Not sure why Van Dijk had given them that much space, but we green time it perfectly, and that is going to be 2-1. They continue to hit us on the attack here. Mane just jockeying. Oh my God. I realized at the last second that I shouldn't have been jockeying with Davies. I probably should have tried to take it off him earlier. Thankfully, that didn't cost us. Come on. Trying to put them on the pressure here. Davies against his former Merseyside rival. We're going through now. Still on. McGinn, it falls fortunately to him. To Hudson-Odoi. Drag back. Finish. Oh, just over. Trippier's running down the line. Oh, my God. Oh, what the fuck's happened there? Liverpool should have probably had a shot there to make that 3-1, but the danger is not over. Mo Salah. Far out, man. It is a corner, though, for Liverpool. They're going to send this one into the area. Van Dijk with the header straight into the gloves of Matt Ryan. Elkerson on the attack here for Liverpool. Naby Keita. Mane. Robertson, terrible pass. Come on, hit him on the counter. Let's get a goal back in this one. Let's get the things tied up. Nice ball over the top. Hudson-Odoi. Looking for some support. Goes through to Philip. Philip. Davies. Davies. Green times, buddy. Just puts it over. What a moment that would have been for the former Evertonian. Laces through it. Oh, my God, man. Mo Salah sending that one into the area. Gilbert. Fuck's sake. That's going to be game, set, and match. A terrible touch. I didn't even try to pass that one, I don't think. Did I? I can't remember. But that one has come off the foot of Gilbert right into the path of Sadio Mane, who's going to pick up a brace. I mean, we saw the first goal he scored that he can belt them in from anywhere. So when we're giving them to him in that situation, he's going to make us pay. Oh, it's been a valiant effort for us. But we're going to be 3-1 down here. Look at the backspin of that one. Final few moments here. A minute and a half left in this one. probably going to be the final attack of the game here for Liverpool. Robertson going to Marco Grujic, who goes to Mane. He wants a hat-trick. He's going to fucking get it. Are you kidding me? Are you fucking kidding me? What can I do in that situation? How can I stop Mane from getting that shot off? Honestly, I'm jockeying perfectly. I'm stopping the position. But somehow, someway, Sadio Mane is finding the back of the net from that position. We are getting absolutely humbled in this one. I mean, look at that. That is so frustrating. We had five people around him. And he still gets the shot off and makes it 4-1. That one moving away from Matt Ryan. I mean, we definitely deserved to lose this game, but 4-1 is not a fair result. There you go, lads. Full time. A 4-1 loss. I think I said my piece there. Definitely a deserved loss, but Mane on another level today. That's a hat trick for him and a frustrating loss. But anyways, fellas, that is going to conclude today's episode. As you can see, a massive episode coming up in episode 25. We have Bournemouth, Chelsea, Newcastle United, and then Chelsea away in the round of 16 in the Carabao Cup. So a lot to get through. Very excited for that episode. But if you guys did enjoy today's episode of the Villa Career Mode series, make sure you leave a like on the video. Make sure you scorpion kick that subscribe button down below if you are new around here. But most importantly, I hope you have a fantastic day. It has been Jared HD here. I am out. Peace.